On a lonely stretch of highway, winding through the forest, one night a motorist found a girl lying unconscious. She had no identification. A bloody knife lay next to her. But she had no knife wounds. Was she a victim or a criminal? Thus our hero was summoned to the hospital to help with a desperate case.
We don't normally work with psychics, but we're desperate. They found her at the edge of the forest. No name, so we can't contact her relatives. No visible signs of injury, but she won't wake up. She's getting weaker, as if something's hindering her treatment psychologically. Please, can you reach her mentally?
The psychic knew what to do. Our hero began a courageous trip into the unknown patient's mind. Even for one so accustomed to the uncanny aspects of life, this journey would be a mysterious one.
Her fever's getting worse. Her body won't be able to stand it much longer. Oh, it's a miracle. Her fever's breaking.
Help! Stop Noise! That's her name! Noise!
It's always a town. A person's mind is an abstract thing, so the psychic must imagine consciousness as a town. Squalid or clean, healthy or ill, sometimes crowded, sometimes desolate. This girl's town is all back alleys and hidden rooms. It's ill and full of secrets. The psychic must uncover every secret, including the most obvious. The girl's name. Until then, this town must be called Jane Doe. Thank you. The psychic found a page of the girl's memory. Priceless.
It's happened again. I keep losing time. I wake up someplace I've never been before, with no idea how I got there. What's happening to me? I'm 20 now. The older I get, the more I lose myself. I feel sick. And my uncle says there's nothing wrong with me. I wish Mom and Dad were still here.
The poor girl has been alone for so long. Maybe she's an orphan. Her problems seem more psychological than physical. They seem linked to the mysterious girl who lives in her mind. The psychic is determined to help her. Plastic cake and sorrowful little flower told the psychic one thing. The girl desperately wanted a protector, a loyal companion. For any other girl, such dreams would seem natural. But here, in Jane Doe, it's beyond a dream. It's a dying hope. Why is this dollhouse separate from the rest of town? Why is she trying to get away from it? the psychic found an empty dog's kennel and a collar. The poor girl had lost what might have been her only friend. But she's haunted by something else. The loss of the dog was only the last straw that broke her. The psychic held another page of the girl's memory, but the handwriting had changed. The page altered. It was disquieting.
Taking over this weak girl was easy. She's a coward. She can't finish anything she starts, and she lacks the courage to save herself. She's just going to have to suffer. She deserves it.
The psychic is shocked by the realization that the girl's personality has split. That's why she lost control of her body. But how did a personality as aggressive as Noise's appear? Only a severe psychological trauma could cause such a thing.
Gone into respiratory arrest. She's weakening. She can't breathe. Poor girl.
Her heart! It stopped. We can't lose her now. Please do something!
The psychic, falling deeper into the poor girl's tortured mind, kept thinking about what might be the blocking force inside her. If it's too dark, the girl is doomed.